Hello. Right, welcome to my second session of Mobile Suit Gundam Online, Taiwanese edition, with extra ping. As you may have noticed in the last video, I was pretty bored because we weren't fighting humans. I have now unlocked over 100 person human battles, which is much more interesting. I've also gone and set myself up with a few almost semi-decent mobile suits, which should give me not an advantage, but should make things a little bit more interesting and varied when we actually get into the game. Answers on a postcard, what any of this means. From the looks of it, it's a daily tournament goal, and if I do it, I get that stuff. I have no idea what happens if I click this. Oh god. I didn't want to click that. So, because that brought up all kinds of gubbins. Daily challenges. I need to do that, that, and that. I have no idea what those are, so I'm not going to get the daily challenges done today. Sometimes I look up the daily challenges to go and see what I could be getting, but for now, it doesn't really matter. I'm just happy to be unlocking anything at all. That would be a blue ticket. I have no idea what that blue ticket is. That's a daily ticket. I assume that gets me some kind of reward for completing one of the daily tasks yesterday. That is a message from somebody that I can't read because I don't read Chinese. They apparently didn't get the hint that I'm English from my profile. It's saying I should click on that. I think that's tutorial, so let's not do that and let's go straight to the store. I've gone and reminded myself roughly how the store works, and I said I'd do a basic demonstration of how to purchase mobile suits on here. So if you're playing this based on watching my videos, you have the vaguest idea what's going on. That's the buy menu, that's the sell menu, that's the code redeem menu, that's the DXEX Gashicon, something like that. Basically that's the booster pack area, and then you can buy back stuff there, and I can never remember what that one is, so I'm not even going to worry about that. So if I go into here, I can purchase packs with the items I've got. Since I don't have any Megabook purchased tickets, I can't buy any of the shiny hotness that's over here. What I can do is, since I have free standard tickets, I could go into here and get booster packs by clicking this button. However, what I can also do, since I have enough money, is go and up myself to 10 of those GP tickets and turn those GP tickets into a bonus 10 pack, which basically means 10 plus a little freebie bonus, and that will unlock various things. So that's given me a gun cannon of some kind, long range support gun cannon set up for standard from the looks of it. I've also acquired an assault gym of some kind, is set up purely rocket launcher and lightsaber, my favorite combination. Normally on a dom though, I prefer it on a brick dom in particular. And that's some sort of Xeon gym equivalent gun cannon type thing. So a bit of long range firepower there and a bit of short range if I wanted to go and build those. So those are blueprints. Actually no, those are rentals because they've got the green backs, but if you get ones of those that are silver or gold, then it means you can then build the part if you have the appropriate extras, and you unlock those extras as you play better, or you can just buy them straight up with GP that you earn for playing well in the game. So basically, the better you play in the game, the easier it is to get hold of stuff like that. I have 6 of these tickets. I have no idea what these type of tickets are. If I click that, it'll probably say you don't have 10 of this. So same with that, I don't know what these green ones are. I think those are like EX special, super special packs, but I only have 6 of those, so I can't really maximize my benefit from spending them. So I'm going to save those for now. I'd prefer to buy them in a big pack of 10. I can also trade stuff in on that menu, I think. or does that... Yeah, I think that's like a booster that gives you extra tickets of things. I seem to have one of those, so what the hell, I might as well spend it and see what it comes up with. I have acquired a big crate of gold. Right, I have no idea what that means or what it does, so moving on. And I also have 9 of these, whatever these are. I think, so this is like a specific set of boosters, a pack, which contains a lot of, I would assume, basic essentials. So there, that's something I really want. That's a Dom, and I love Doms. Doms are fantastic, so I'd love to get hold of one of those. It's got really nice selection of weapons, superb saber, really fast, really maneuverable. It still has a rocket launcher as well. I freaking love them. They're my favourite type of mobile suit by far, so I'd love to unlock one of those. And I tend to prefer that, and Goose are really nice as well in close, but they have this fantastic whip that allows them to attack from long range with hand-to-hand combat attacks, and it's just great. I love playing those. They're much more fun than the basic Zakus that I currently have. So this is kind of like your basic booster packs that you're getting, which can fill out your roster. So let's go and pick up a few of these whilst we're here. Obviously there'll be something in the doobly-doo below if you want to skip on and get straight into the battles. I have unlocked some kind of assault gym. This assault gym has some weird lancey type weapon. I'll actually have to look that up because I have no idea how that's set up. So this is obviously some sort of melee focus. That's not a melee weapon, that's a distance weapon. You can tell because the melee weapons have these two stats, which I think is like damage and speed. Whereas that has lots and lots of different statistics that sort of define how it works. The other way you can tell is kind of by these symbols, which give you a hint about how they work. I can't remember what the symbols mean precisely. That one's special attack, so you can charge it. That one is explosive, that sort of thing. But I don't remember how all of these work. That's some kind of rocket pods, those are grenades. And you'll be able to unlock those, and I'll demonstrate how to do that in a second once I'm through here. But I'll go through each of these, and there'll be a skip button you can use if you want to get past it, but this is just a little taster of the game. I'm not going to be doing this every time, I won't be showing it every time, I'm just showing it for once, so people have a sense of how the game works for future episodes, so when I say, oh, I got this by doing the purple booster packs, you know what I'm talking about. And speaking of boosts, there's a booster pack. Ooh, that's pretend, almost got a red. Reds are good, but it doesn't actually matter because when it doesn't affect which kind of box it lands on all anyway. And it's just going to give me a little boost upgrade, helper things. Those boost upgrades, unsurprisingly, are used to increase the boost of your mobile suits when we go into our garage. So going to here, that's all the stuff I've unlocked, including the daily rewards that have come in. So there'll be lots and lots of stuff there. 149 days, I wonder what that means. Anyway, so if we jump into the lab, or the hangar, or whatever it's actually supposed to be called, we can see that I have built myself a Zaku 2S. It's got a big axe and a whack-off bazooka. It's pretty slow, but it has the advantage that it can work in both space and land, and that's one of the things I really like about the Zeon mobile suits, is they tend to be very, even the low-end ones, tend to be very good in space, which is a nice advantage. These two are rentals, so that's a sniper rental, that's an assault rental. That's a heavy, I believe is the technical term, a heavy Zaku 2F, and that's an assault Zaku 2S. So that's a very attack focused group I've got there. This one is almost the same, except I've got this gun tank. You can tell from that little thing that it's for indirect fire bombardment, and you operate it like artillery. It's kind of a strategic thing that you can use. I've got 13 more deployments of that. I've only got 4 of this rental, but because it's a rental, I can't renew those. But since I've got 13 uses of this available, I'll go into here and spend that much GP, which as you can probably tell isn't very much, to get that back up to 20 deployments. It just means you have to spend a little bit of expenditure when you deploy your mobile suits. So if I go into here, these are the mobile suits I have available. That's a high-end gun cannon rental that I've got. That's saying that I could build this, but I don't have the relevant parts. I need 4 of each of those parts. I don't have them. That's a water-based assault suit, so I don't actually have a dedicated water suit, so if we come up against a water map, that would be really handy to have. What I can then do, I can spend a gold ticket to increase the chance that I'll get a bunch of bonuses when I build it. If I click on this and do that, yes, I need to actually spend the MP to do it that way. But basically, if I had each of those, so I can go and buy those in turn. I'm sure you can automatically do this somehow, but what the hell, we'll go in. It's not like it's a very expensive thing to buy. And this will add it into my hangar and give it me as an option in future. By choosing to use a gold ticket instead of a silver ticket, I greatly increase the chance of getting a starting bonus with it. Do I really need MB just to build that? That seems weird. I click no. That just stops it from happening. Normally, I don't know what's special about this one in particular, but normally you don't have to spend actual monies to get hold of these, unless that's not saying that I have 2 of them, but in fact that I need to spend 2 megabucks to get it. That's always possible. Maybe I don't have any production things like that. So I'd also like to get this goof. That's just a rental, you can tell because of the green squiggly bit. So I do that again. It's asking me for megabucks. Oh, I see. Right, that's why. Ah, right. This is hangar space. So it's saying I don't have enough space in my hangar to put another mobile suit in there. I'm 8 out of 8. So I need to get rid of some of my existing mobile suits if I want to add new ones. I have a serious excess on some of these, but I'll wait for that rental to disappear and then decide where to go from there. I think that's my current hangar there. So these are all of the ones I got unlocked. I probably want to have at least one repair in there just in case. I don't need... What do I not need? I don't need this many assault things. I certainly don't need an assault gym when I've got so many other great things. So I believe that is how I delete it. So yeah, there we go. Deleted that. And I can now go in and acquire myself this new water mobile suit, as I was trying to do earlier. Right, so select the gold ticket, got all the parts, go into there, click that, and it'll produce the suit. And I now have a brand new level 8 suit, which is fantastic, and that's why you save those gold tickets for producing these. As I upgrade it, its level will increase to reflect the upgraded stats that I'm giving it, and it will cost more points, and you can't have a stable full of just really, really high-end, super powerful mobile suits. So we're going to here. I'm able to unlock upgraded weapons for it, for example. So that's some kind of harpoon, given that this is a water type, so I'm guessing that's going to be his primary weapon. But my nature is usually to go for the beam saber, so I'm going to get an upgraded beam saber. What does the most damage? The most damage comes from having the highest end one. So let's go to that. We will do that. Right, now it's actually going and purchasing all of the parts that I need for it rather than forcing me to do it one by one. So it's just the fact that my hangar was full earlier that was causing that problem. I've now upgraded it to a maximum lightsaber. It's technically a beam saber, but I like calling them lightsabers anyway. And that is, I think, objectively better than I started off with, so hurrah! then I can also upgrade the stats on that weapon by doing this, and I can spend some of these mechanic tickets and master tickets to then, which I've unlocked as I've been going around, and you can also buy them for GP or MD as appropriate, and that can give me the ability to increase the stats a bit, and it's a little bit of an increase, and my weapon is now a tiny bit more powerful than it was. Not a huge increase as you can see, but it all makes a difference and it gets you closer to the higher levels as well. I'll also upgrade the harpoon job whilst I'm here, can't see why not. Let's look at what model I'd actually like. I think we're going to go for... can't remember what each of these mean. I used to have them memorized. But I think usually there's one set of options which is quite a bit better than the defaults. I think that's the one I want to go for. So, although that's the one that's really expensive. Let's try that. We'll try that one. I probably won't use this for a while anyway, because I'll only use it on maps that have a significant water presence, because that is a pretty much a water-only mobile suit. It won't operate very well outside water, which is why I'm not putting it in my default hangar. As the rentals disappear, I'll get more space in the hangar and I can produce more mobile suits over time. You also get upgrades to the mobile suits for using them in a battle. And on that note, let's go and find a battle. Let's go for that's group lobby, that's individual lobby. I'll go into the individual lobby, and I think all I have to do is click on that. Yep, there we go. And it will now start matchmaking me with around 100 other players on one of the main maps. Now, I don't think this is a very good time, so I don't know how many people are going to be online. But we can see how it goes. Whilst it's doing matchmaking here, you can continue to go into your lobby and look at your mobile suits, which is nice. So, just to give you a sense of what I've got, if we're in space, I've got this sniper suit, I've got that heavy, and you'll notice that there's a bit of a theme there, sort of Zaku's with bazookas is my usual sort of starting setup. I have that gun tank, because gun tanks are really good for strategic support on some maps, and they tend not to die, so if I'm just charging in with the Zaku's and getting completely murdered, I can just sit back and farm some points by using the gun tank in a strategic way. If I pop back to here, I should be able to also have a look at my character. So it says, you know, one win, no losses, a bunch of other statistics which I can't read because I can't read Chinese. That's like my title, I think, and I unlock those and can get better titles. You can also get... this is what other people will see when they look at yours, and it shows you what levels your, what affinity you have with your mobile suit. So the more you take them out, the higher the level we'll have on here, and that's actually tied to a specific variant. So I think that, for example, would be, yeah, that's all repair. And what I really want is one of these Zaku type repair things, but I don't have one at the moment. So we'll wait to get into the game. There'll be a nice little skip button for those of you who don't want to listen to me blabbering, filling in time whilst this is happening. There's a lot of other stuff going on here. There's like events and tickets and other things that you can get. It's got a little bit of, you know, that free-to-play gambling style stuff in there. But not only am I not interested in that stuff, but I have no idea how to read most of it, because they have to explain all of the concepts to you, because it's not intuitive to a gamer how any of that gambling stuff would work, so I'm not going to go anywhere near it. I'm not interested in pachinkos anyway. One thing that is worth noting, this is my daily goal. I get 2 gold tickets if I play 6 games. If I play 18 games, I get 4. And I can't remember how long that is. It's worth also mentioning how the ranking system on this works. You can go down in rank as you get farther into the game, and it's kind of like StarCraft or League of Legends in that you can go down leagues if you don't get a consistent performance over a certain amount of time. So those points that I was getting in the previous game, you can see from the points that I was getting in the previous game, that is a rough representation of how I'm doing, and then over multiple games I start to build up a picture of how well I'm doing. I think if I maybe click on there, click on myself, I might pull that up. No, it doesn't. No, it isn't that one. Nope. There is a button somewhere around here, which, oh god, what have I done? Nothing major. That allows me to change my mobile suits. I don't need my underwater one for the time being. I could swap my underwater mobile suit in now if I wanted to, but I have no reason to want to do that. Interestingly as well, I noticed that on the Taiwanese servers as well, nobody chooses to be the commander, which I continue to find bizarre. But yes, at the end, certainly at least at the end of a match, I can see what my score streak is, and if I consistently get bad results, I'll get kicked down. If I consistently get higher point results, I'll get pushed up. So over time, you'll see me getting more and more obsessed with grabbing a few more extra points. And the point system on this is fairly good. You get points for supporting people, you get points for assists, you get points for capping and doing objectives. So you're not punished if you choose not to play in a heavy combat style. And I like to do a mix. I usually, once I've got a dom, I like to maneuver across the map, picking off people with the beam saber and generally making a nuisance of myself, skirting across the map, seizing objectives, pushing the opposing team back. And one of the nice things about this game is even though there's over 100 people in a lot of games, you still feel like you're making a significant difference to the outcome of the game when you're playing well, which cannot be said for most games of this size. Alright, let's do this. I have unlocked GP simply for playing a match. Fair enough. Ooh, I like this map. Yes, although I don't have a particularly fast mobile suit. That's a problem. What's probably my fastest one? That one. I'll take that one. I probably want to go from that. Oh no, it's that point that I want to go from. And I need to make sure I immediately hit the boosters as soon as we jump into the map, because otherwise I'm going to slam down on the ground and it'll take me ages to get into that center area where all the fun happens. Take the FS, which is a really nice little melee bazooka job. Yeah, there we go. And make sure to grab that, and that gives me the ability to bez over here. But unfortunately, because my suit sucks, I'm not going to make it that far because I don't have enough boost on this particular mobile suit, and we'll have to go here, which is really, really quite unfortunate. Yeah, it's a very good melee mobile suit, but it's not got much speed, and this is the problem with Zaku's in general, they don't have much speed. Is this the same map? Oh no, this is a new map. It must be based on the previous maps. So you notice that our team's kind of spreading out, seizing objectives, getting into position, and you'll see little battle lines get drawn across the map as we negotiate and move through. And it's important that we kind of keep an eye on what's going on behind us and ahead of us. And, woo, coming from the left as well. And once I get back into the habit of it, I'll be darting around like a madman. But for now, I'll just be happy to sit behind the lines and pick off anyone who gets a little bit too smug. No, that's gonna hurt. Now, I don't believe I have any homing weapons on this, which is gonna make attacking people in this wide open space quite difficult. But what I can do is do what I can to help defend this point, or seize it at the very least. Ow. Oh yeah, this is the fire support variant, so this is one of the version 3 hacks, which means in a hand-to-hand combat situation like that, I'm going to get completely murdered. So if I take out my actual melee assault, let's use that, and we can jump in right behind their lines, because our team is doing fantastic, but that's nice. Points! I have points, I'm not last, woohoo! Life goal achieved, oh my god. Yeah, that's a hilarious landing. See, that's what I want. I want one of those, hovers and has great big rocket launcher. That's much more fun. Although, what I'm going to do here, I'm going to sit and camp over here, behind, where? Round the back. Oh god, no, wrong weapon. See, this is why DOMs are scary, because they allow you to sneak around the enemy line and do stuff like that, like he was doing to us there. So what I wanted to do is this. Ow. And then that'll fire a bunch of shots, stuff like that. But of course, you don't want to do that when you're out in the open, because you get destroyed. So now that I've demonstrated that, I will never do that again. So that's how the support variant mobile suits work. Bear in mind that you don't get penalized at all for not charging in. You don't get penalized at all for charging in and getting killed. So there's no downside to getting killed, so it encourages you to get stuck into the action. The only thing is, if you're like I currently am, you can get into a situation where all of your mobile suits are on cooldown, which is great, so I want to play relatively carefully now until some of my mobile suits are back up available for my use. In the meantime, I can pick off people with this bazooka. Or I can pretend I'm picking off people with this bazooka and actually just be failing miserably. I feel like this is not a good place to be stood at the moment. Let's get out of there. Yep, that wasn't a good place to be stood at all. Ow! Excellent, I've got zero kills. That's how terrible I am at this. So, I was hoping that the fact that I was quite good at the Japanese game and the fact that I'm no longer playing with lag would translate into me doing alright on here, but because I've never done these particular maps before, I have no idea where the enemy attacks are coming from, and that makes it very difficult to stop, say, side attacks from coming in and beating us, or, you know, I'm checking down here to make sure we're not getting attacked on the flanks, but then people are just sort of casually careening in from the sides. Oh yeah, I'd forgotten about that. You can be floating and kind of hover around at a decent height whilst also using the boost, and that makes it very hard to shoot because you move really fast. But most of the Zakus that I've got, one of the downsides to them is that they don't have a huge amount of boosts, because these aren't really high-end mobile suits, so you tend to get exhausted rather fast. And being exhausted basically means you're dead, and you've probably seen a lot where I run out of the boost there and I'm just a sitting duck to the enemies. But you want to use the boost to get into position when you're fighting the opponents as well. I don't have any bazookas left, that's unfortunate. Let's try... Now I'm remembering. I'm remembering how to fight in spaces like this. So the trick to fighting in spaces like this is to, first of all, not run out of energy like I just did, but also, if I go to here, I can boost, fire, get a bit of fire off here. Unfortunately, my weapons are no good for this, but if I had a decent weapon, I could be firing out rockets and such like in that position, and potentially do quite well. But again, I don't know the maps, I don't know, I have a clue where things are, so for the time being, I'm mostly going to be getting my ass kicked for at least the first dozen or few games until I get back into the habit of how all the game mechanics work. but little pot shots like the one I got there, where I just kind of picked up that free rocket shot as the sort of thing that I specialise in. So there we go, that kind of hit. I can usually, once I know the map and know what I'm doing well and have like a dom or something, I can reliably get hits like that. Ow. Now, I could probably avoid that guy, but I'm not really paying enough attention to what equipment he had. He was obviously going to come at me. I was trying to keep my distance, but there wasn't a huge amount I could do under those specific circumstances. Since we're in an enclosed space, I'll probably just take the fire support here and bombard from outside this external area. That wasn't nice. This is one of those, oh no, I was hoping it was one of those weapons where if you have a lock it actually helps you get the hit. But managing that energy meter is extremely important if you're in any kind of offensive role, because it allows you to dodge out of the way of attacks and stuff. I should probably take out a support suit if I had a decent one, and start healing people and just generally getting used to the maps, but I figured get some action for now and show people how the game's supposed to work, even if I'm not doing it correctly. Oh, and knowing where people set up these repair points in safe places around the map, it can make a huge difference. Once you find one of these, if you use it at a choke point, you can essentially go for up to like 5-10 minutes just you going back to the repair point without getting killed, which allows you to get off a hell of a lot of shots. We've also got a those sensors there which allow us to see enemies. So if I switch, oh, it's not G, there's A button, Z, no Z, no 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 no, Z will make me go back to base. Q? Not Q. K? Ah, definitely not K. So there is something that makes that map in the top right zoom in to a close range range, but I can't remember what key it is for now. And that's not good. I think I can fire over this, as long as I have a target lock, we'll fire down. But I don't need a target lock for that to work. So that. No, but it's got a decent enough range, it doesn't matter. They don't seem to mind me, which is nice. Okay. Oh god, they found me. Okay, that's a nice little choke point there that they're all crowding around. As they come through. And it's odd, you'd think giant stonking mobile suits that move really slowly, you wouldn't manage to get too many different styles of combat, but pretty much every single room that I've been in here, they've been in a slightly different way that I've been playing, and having to adjust to the way that the combat is occurring around me. Go to here. I've currently got this gun tank, and this gun tank has almost no maneuverability, but I can do this. Bombard from long range. Those guys are coming down that trench. I can fire off a few shots and get moving into a better position. It helps the team out, it allows us to secure locations, so I now know they're fighting up there, so I can maybe consider firing a few shots into that rally. Unlikely I'm going to hit anyone since I don't know the map, but once you know the map, shots like that can make a huge difference to the outcome of the match in the long term. Let's try firing this cannon. It's got a decent sort of explosive range, so if I position it right, I should be able to hit that. Oh god, hit that entrance. Ow. That was my face. But the problem with playing something like this is somebody can come up in a much more maneuverable mobile suit like that and eat your face, which is what just happened. Fear my weedly little machine gun cannon. Mwah. And you'll notice that I did a lot more damage to that enemy once I properly ranged it. I knew what enemy I was facing, even though I was in completely one mobile suit. Since he was fighting my friend, I had plenty of opportunity to fire with a machine gun. If I hadn't switched weapon, I would have been completely stuffed in that situation. So it's always worth paying a lot of attention to the specifics of your situation. Also looking at the map, which I've not been doing nearly as much of as I should do. And I'm literally not doing anything to that. That's depressing. Now he's going to try and close with me and go for that point. I'm not going to contest the point because I'm in a long range suit, but I can draw him out into the open to get killed like that. Now, if somebody would be so kind as to give us a heal. Apparently, I'm not going to be getting one of those. Is there no, there isn't a repair in that team. That's a shame. But since I'm in a support suit, I can probably just get away with sitting back and supporting the rest of the team for a bit. Oh my god, I'm dead last on our team. How bad am I playing? It's going to take me a long time to get used to, well, not lag shooting for a start. I was missing all of my shots initially because I didn't have any sense of how to hit things when I wasn't playing with tons of lag. It's interesting that I'm playing worse now though, when there's hardly any lag. I'd have thought I'd be doing better than I am currently doing, but then I also have really bad mobile suits. As much as I love Zaku's, they're really not very good when it comes to how much you can do with them. They have very little energy, which really sort of sets them back. And there's a sniper. Bollocks, went away. That's a hero. He will easily kill me. The idea is that you sort of team up to kill the hero characters, and then the person who eventually kills it gets a massive bonus, but also everyone who contributes gets bonuses for just for taking part. Isn't that lovely? I think if we hold the central point, we should just about win this game. And since you get a lot of points at the end for your team winning, you have a lot of impetus to defend a point like this and make sure your team actually wins, because it really helps your overall final score. Can't guarantee that it's going to happen, but it helps. Get into the fire support mode, jump out, fire, and just kind of repeat until a satisfied enemy has been saturated with enough BS. Not the most exciting way of playing, but you can get results doing that. Oh, there's some Gundams floating around on platforms up there. Very cool, but not terribly practical, since you can never hit anything doing that. God, I wish I had a DOM. The bazooka shots from the DOM would be killing them instantly. And I'd have way more boost power as well. I was using one of those. It'll take a while to get the necessary tickets to get one of those, though. Oh, and I got swarmed. Everybody else has retreated and or died. It happens. So, 31 points, that's a terrible score, but needed. I'd love to actually get some close-in combat and demonstrate that for you guys, but that would require me to survive long enough to use it. One nice thing, because it's third person, you can get away with sitting behind stuff, assuming they don't have sensor upgrades, and then swiping at people as they move past. You can be surprisingly stealthy in a giant-ass suit like that, and that's how you'll get a lot of melee kills. But the Zaku isn't fantastic for melee. You're not going to kill them in one hit, which is what you really want from your melee stuff. I got one kill and basically no support stuff. So what I might do next time is take out that really awful support thing and just heal people up and get used to what I need to be doing. The X ticket, that's nice. So I can get another one of those green booster packs. So that's my overall points. Those overall points are the thing that will, after 7 games, will define what rank I am. And what sort of rough rank I am limits what level I'm able to get to. That's the upgrade to my mobile suits as well. Go to here, I can go and open up crates. Fair enough, there was nothing interesting in there anyway. Not that it makes any difference to the statistical odds of what you're going to get. Just makes you feel good. And I do like a game which makes you feel good. I'm going to drop out of there, and then I'll set up my team to use the support mobile suit. Or even better, let's see if I've got a better support mobile suit that I can use. I do not. That's a shame. I have that, which is a... I would get that, but I don't see much point. So in my hangar I currently have this bugger, which is kind of awful. I'll use that and I'll put it in place of that, I think. Swap that out with that. And I can use that as support in the next match that I'm in. I'll also drop the close-in guy for the space stuff, so if you're going to a space mission I'll take the repair one instead, because on the space missions there's a lot more wide open spaces. I'm unlikely to be hitting people with usually more open spaces, not this place, but usually it's harder to hit people with the melee, although I used to do really well with the Dom on Rick Dom on Barracoon. I used to do fantastically well with those. I think I completed some daily goal or other, which is nice, go me. And since we got the green ticket I saw, I can go into here and pick up... Ooh, I just need one more and I can do the whole series of those, which would be nice. Whilst I'm here, I'll also go and grab... Two packs of those, two big packs of those. How did I only end up with 14 from that? Anyway, let's do that. There we go. That's what we get. Who knows, we might even get a decent repair mobile suit. Heavy Gundam, gym type thing, rental, don't care. Gun cannon, I like gun cannons. Gun cannons are much more fun to play with than your the supports that I currently have. I like that big cannon, it works really well. I think it homes as well, I could be wrong about that. It's another Gundam assault. I keep getting Federation suits, I don't like Federation suits. Stop giving me Federation suits. Normally, in the Japanese version, you would pick between Zero or Federation to get one or the other. And ooh, it's a shiny thing. Is that a rental? No, I don't think that is a rental. That's a high-end gym, which is to say it's a high-end shit thing. But I might want to use that instead of one of my Zaku's and just beef up the beam saber on it. It's an option. We'll see how it goes. I also acquired a very nice gun cannon. And... is that a, some, it's definitely a Xeon water one anyway. Probably some kind of grabby claw thing. Yep, you always have some kind of grabby claw thing. So that's another one that will be really handy to have if I start doing underwater missions, because those are specialised for that purpose. Excellent. I will cover those, and obviously I got a bunch of other stuff in there as well, which all contributes to reducing the cost of upgrading my suits later. So I could go into my suits now and upgrade them, but I'll do that off screen. Again, I'm just demonstrating the basic core game loop. Play a match, get your freebies, get your booster packs, choose your mobile suits, upgrade everything, and then dive into another game. And normally that loop would go much faster, but I'm being absolutely useless. Yeah, I know you're telling me about these, but I have no idea what I'm supposed to click. I mean, I don't even know what I just did. Yeah, that just brought on my character, that's not helpful. So, why are you flashing at me? What are you flashing at me about? I can't do anything with it. It's just... there. Is there something in here that I'm supposed to be reading? Yeah, I get it. There's daily... oh, I just wanted me to check the daily challenges. So, like, 31 points, I'm guessing that is. So I need to get 200 points. And that'll go towards my challenge goal. I'm guessing that's kills, so I need 15 kills. And that's probably two objectives capped or something of that nature. Cool. Okay. Let's jump right into the game again. It's a surprisingly addictive core game loop. It's been very, very carefully honed. It's like an EA game almost. It's very moorish. You want to go back to it after playing a session. You think, oh, just another one. I'll just have another game. I'm playing FIFA as well. I'm playing FIFA career mode, and I've done a full season in the past week where I got loaned out to Blackpool, of all things. And I went to Blackpool as somebody who wasn't apparently worth playing at Huddersfield Town, and came out as a superstar with a hat-trick for England in my one international cap. And Blackpool went on to win a double, and I myself, I think, have a value of around 30 million now in the game, 30 million quid. So, yeah, nice going. So I'm now going to be playing for Huddersfield Town, and I'm guessing that my ratings are going to drop when I actually have to play reasonably well. Not just playing League 2 football, but we'll see. Not what we're here to play anyway. So, hopefully it shouldn't take too long. Depending on when you jump on the game, it can take up to 10 minutes to find a game, or sometimes it just does it instantly. You've got to bear in mind that these games are very long, so it actually means for it to only take a few minutes for us to get into a game means that there must be at least 1,000 people actively playing. It's not like this is a game where there's not lots of people playing. I mean, you can tell just from the chat rooms, people are busy chatting. This is only one of the many chat rooms, and loads of stuff is happening. Everybody's busy, and I think I'm wondering if this might show us who's online at the moment. Look in there, yeah. I should probably translate that at some point. I do actually have the means to translate some of the hand, so I might do that in a bit. Don't know what that button means. Oh, we'll select. So later on, you get more interesting maps and more interesting missions, and you can sort of pick what rules you want, but this is just the very basic capture the point type missions. There's usually little side things going on as well, like if you take energy supplies to a ship, sometimes that'll greatly increase your points, or but those usually come later on. when you're higher rank, it sort of gradually introduces things, which is why it's not too difficult to play it even if you don't understand Japanese or Chinese, because you can fumble your way through it. Makes me wonder actually how difficult it is for Japanese players to play the Chinese version, because I'm guessing they can read a lot of the words, because the kanji is roughly the same. And kanji and han are broadly the same, it's just that the han uses kanji for grammar as well. So you'd be able to read the words, just not the grammar. So playing a Chinese game probably wouldn't be nearly as difficult for a Japanese person as it is for me. Hopefully once I'm better at Japanese, that division will shorten. I'm also really looking forward to the point at which I don't suck at this game, but I definitely need more practice before I can say that I'm there. Yeah, I don't think this is necessarily a very good time to get into the game. It's taking about 5 minutes to load into the game. Probably means that most of the players in Hong Kong are actually asleep right now. Which, would that make sense? Yeah, it's probably early morning for them. It's probably like, you know, maybe 5 or 6 o'clock. So it wouldn't be entirely surprising if they were... 5 or 6 in the morning, it wouldn't be at all surprising if they weren't playing this game. And might be mostly international players. That's interesting. Am I? Oh, right, I was on the very last page, that's why. I was there by myself. That's what our commander, if we ever get one, will have access to, but for some reason nobody in the Taiwanese version ever takes the commander slot, and I can't understand why. Anyway, once I get to a rank where I'm the most experienced person on the server, I might try taking on the commander ranks, because I do quite enjoy playing commander. One of the few things once you understand the maps, you can really make a big difference by playing the commander role, but people seem exceptionally shy about picking it up, but not about spamming, I notice. So environment there, it's saying it's a land environment as opposed to water or space. I know that's a water kanji, so that must be the space kanji slash han. That also happens to be the kanji for big, so mission, large scale combat or something of that. That's number of players, that's time available. And will be some kind of rules for it. This is set on a colony in space, but because it's a fully enclosed colony, land mobile suits are still valid to take out. So since we're on a land one, these are the ones available to us. There's probably not much looking at that. There's probably not much in the way of water, so no reason to take any water suits. I don't really like those in direct fire. Zaku models, I prefer using the gun cannon because it has direct fire artillery. You can lay down a bunch of barrage like I was failing to do earlier. But again, these are new maps, I've never played any of these maps, I have no idea what's going on, and people are just running circles around whatever I pick anyway. Congratulations, you participated, have some gold coins! Good question actually, which one would I want to take for just starting out? Probably that, because I'm most likely to end up sneaking up on somebody at the start of the match. We'll go down the main one. Once I'm a bit more comfortable with it, we'll start trying to seize these objectives on the edges. Tell you what, we'll go for these, because this is the side where all the objectives are. So we'll try racing for the objectives. Because my suit doesn't have much boost, I'm probably not going to get any points out of it, but hey, you can dream. There we go, right, sneak in there, get a few points to start me off with for contributing to the capture of these points. There we go, and if we bez off to point 3, other people have already gone and taken that. But that does mean I'm second on the team, which I ain't going to stay there. But technically, for contributing to the team, I am number two. And again, I've forgotten the boost. I used to have all of the boost meters memorized in my memory, so I would never run out of boost. Show you how much I've actually played the Japanese version of this game, but I've forgotten all of that since, which is a shame. Okay, we should then theoretically be outnumbering the opponents here. Oh my god, there's some kind of objective thing going on, and our players are swarming them, and they're swarming us. Looks like some kind of weird race to each other's base on this map. That is a water suit. I'm not sure why that's there. I want that, gimme. Haha. Right, I can also duck, so I'm less likely to get attacked, but the downside to ducking is you become a static target if the opponents sneak up on you. I'm now 30th. Yeah, this is really hard to stay on top of the points, so I'm guessing all those people who attacked really early just harvested a bunch of points by attacking the enemy base like that. Good work, that man. Whoa! Zegook, I think that might be. Or Zegook. Goog. Definitely something with Goog, I think. I really need to brush up on my mobile suit Gundam War. So everybody's currently spawning from there from the looks of it. So let's get involved and do some repairing and maybe set up some points. Yeah, that's some kind of point, probably a repair point, I think. So use that to set up a sort of forward choke point. It's not that this suit is totally hopeless, it's so slow. If an opponent picks you out, it's really, 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 really easy for them to kill you. It can be frustrating, yeah. So somebody's picked me out here and I probably have no chance of surviving if they actually do come after me. Oh, let's plonk that down there. That's a more heal point for anyone who can use it, and oh, and we've lost already. Wow, that's a weird map. OMG there in the bottom left from somebody. Yeah, OMG is exactly what I'd say about that. What the hell happened, guys? We were all on the attack as well. And that's probably why we lost, because we were all on the attack. Wow, those are some really low points. But I didn't come last! Yay! I'm professional. Get another green ticket, which is always nice, and slowly but surely increasing that value. So currently I want to be aiming for around 50 or 60 per game, whilst I'm currently playing awfully and the games are really short. But as I get better at it, I'll be aiming for more like 200, 300 and trying to get up into the higher ranks. I know I can do that, it's just going to take a while to get back into the swing of it. I think I'll probably do one more match today, and then we can get stuck in, and just for the sake of it, I will also go and spend one of those booster packs in the Gashicon. That's it, Gashicon, that's what it's called. So it's a green one. Yes! I can finally get the enhanced green one, which I assume is the best chance of getting whatever this mobile suit is. Ooh, if I get a red, I'll get the fanciest stuff. Do I get a red? No, I get the worst one. Of course I get the worst one. I believe... Wah! What did I just click? I'll click something a bit more useful there. Oh, I've unlocked stuff. I don't quite know what a lot of this stuff is. Mechanic ticket for mechanic tickets. Handy. Yeah, I can upgrade my mobile suits quite a lot with that. And I assume somewhere in there there's probably some stuff, but I didn't unlock any blueprints, which is problematic, because the blueprints are the thing that I was really after with those. So, jump back in and start looking for a new match. Really, I should start looking for a new match and then do all of the Gashcon stuff. In fact, if I go into here, just to tide over whilst we're waiting, let's see if we got any... Nope. And yes, I can get that up to 10. And we can just purchase some really basic stuff just to tide us over and keep us interested whilst we're waiting. So what we got? We got some kind of support Zaku, some kind of repair gem, yay! Like I need a second one of those fucking things. I think you can, if you've got extra blueprints, you can trade them in to help upgrade the initial mobile suit, so there is benefit to getting duplicates, and these two are rentals, but I'm not seeing a Rick Dom rental, which is the only kind of rental that I care about right now. What I will try and do, let's go to the buy store. Those all require mega books, so those aren't of any use to me. But I think in here, I think that was a sort of pre-bought, pre-fab, pre-made suit. If you go into there, I could have sworn there was a way to get hold of like DOMs and stuff through here. Apparently not. And those are just your basic support things if you really want to buy a specific mobile suit. Mobile suit. Jesus Christ, I'm not American. We need to get out of that habit. Let's check in there. Do I have a DOM? I do not seem to have a DOM. How can I have so many mobile suits available and none of them are DOMs? Bah. Bah and fiddlesticks. I'm half tempted to take out the gun tank and replace it with that goof. Yeah, let's do that. Grab the goof over here, and then it'll tell me, oh, you can't do that, because what am I actually not using in here? The ones that I'm not using, that's that quite neat assault thing. I'm not using this sniper gym, and probably never will, so let's get rid of that dude. And then I can purchase a... goof from here. That's my rental, so that'll fill up a slot. And that's ground only, not surprisingly. So I will replace that. Shiny. You have unlocked all the things. My lord, this is taking a long time. It really is not an ideal time to be playing this. Let's jump into Gashcon and get another basic pack whilst I'm here. Just keeping everything being nice and busy. Well, that was a wash. Ooh, an actual Gundam! Fan-freaking-tastic! Right, I'm actually getting something decent now. This is the kind of thing that you really want. It's an actual, proper, bona fide Gundam. Depending on how you outfit it, it's got a nice... it's a nice, versatile, high-energy, high-cost mobile suit. The kind of thing that you really want in your team. So, that's fantastic. Sniper, Zaku, yeah, nobody wants you. And that is a rental gun cannon, just like I don't have enough of those already. Fine. But yes, that Gundam, I probably want to try and see if I can get right now, because having a proper Gundam is kind of awesome and certainly beats the shit out of these Zarkus. Even if they are leveled up Zarkus, it's still way better. Let's drop that fire support one. I don't mind keeping the rentals in because I need to use those up anyway. There's no downside to having loads of them. Now, if I want to build the Gundam, I'll need to also clear out a slot somewhere in my setup. So let's get. That's a rental. I don't really want to trash a rental. I might as well use it for a bit. And then. Alright, let's get rid of that. Yes, I know. I was probably saying I can't get rid of it because I'm currently using it. Let's. That. So. Yep, that'll put it back in the hangar. And then I can. Now get rid of it. Well, I'm also no longer using that gun tanky type thing anywhere, so I can get rid of that. Should be good. It's a Zeon one. I didn't realise that was a Zeon one. It must be a sort of imitation model. And I also wanted to get rid of the standard F. I'm not too fussed about losing that. I think I get like a ticket back as well if I do that, which is nice. So let's build me a Gundam. Where's the Gundam? Where is the Gundam? Bit confused here. It was there and now it's not there, and oh, I probably need to actually get my gift stone. That's why it's not showing up. I also don't have a valid squad if I were to jump in right now. That would be bad. So that is a proper bona fide gun cannon, which is nice. I also, if I come out of there and go back in, I should have a proper bona fide normal gun model Gundam. Except I don't. Why don't I? Ah, there it is. Ha! Okay. Purchase. Yes, use the gold ticket. It's Gundam. It's perfectly worth a gold ticket. Pay the GP to get all the parts and ta-da! Level 9 Gundam. Fantastic. I need to fill up that slot anyway. So that's now all the space ones I have. So I only have 4 space models at the moment. And let's pull out that Zarku for the time being and put the Gundam in instead. And what I really want is a seriously high-end saber. Yes, that's why I clicked it, because I want you to do it. Yes, and again. Yes. Thank you. Okay, so that gets me a high-end saber. Yeah, let's upgrade that once anyway. I think. Now this greatly increases the cost of the mobile suit every time I do this, but wow, that's got some damage. That is fantastic. I mean, it looks... Right, okay, so that's a faster version, and that's the heavy damage version that does tons. I'll stick with the default for now, sort of somewhere in the middle. I could get the sort of dedicated missile launcher as well, but yeah, we'll go with that. We'll go with how I've set it up for now. Can I upgrade some of its core attributes? Yeah, but I don't have any mechanic tickets left. Let's just increase that. I think that's like call. Right. I'll wait until I've got more tickets. I can probably buy more tickets anyway if I really wanted to. I've only got two more uses left on that Zaku. So once I've got that out of the way, I can start populating. Do I have any other space bound things? Oh, I've got tons of stuff that can go into space if I need to. Probably that gun cannon. Oh god, I didn't mean to actually build that. I didn't realise I already had the parts for it. Well, so yeah, I got that gun tank rental, which I can use to then replace the Zaku once it's ready. Why do people keep sending me messages? I can't read what you're sending me at all. I have no idea what you're telling me. It makes me so sad. Oh, and the longer you have to wait, the more bonuses you get. So you can probably see from that that I'm getting more tickets and a 50% bonus to the GP that I'm getting from it. So you're rewarded for your patience if you're waiting a while like we're doing here. But yes, I wouldn't recommend playing the game at this time because some of the Taiwanese folk are on to go on the game earlier if you want to have fun. So that is an all-round Gundam. Pretty fantastic if you ask me. I'll be looking forward to using that and leveling it up and taking advantage. That's a rental goof, which is fantastic for hand-to-hand combat. Now the downside to both of those is they're land only, so limited in where I can deploy them, but superb. That's all round, whereas the goof is definitely hand-to-hand combat. Heavily set up for that. In fact, why does that not have its whip? That's a non-standard build. Either way, its beam saber is absolutely fantastic as well. I'm not sure what that weapon is. A repair, GM, gym, whatever. Yeah, fine. That's just there to get me some points when I'm still learning the maps. And that, I've got a few uses left on that nice little fire support Zaku to keep me out of the fray and just score me a few cheap kills. In space, we currently have the sniper Zaku. We have, I really wish I could remember how to zoom. We have the repair gym, we have the fire support Zaku, and we also have just a general purpose assault Zaku, the S model, which has a bazooka and an axe, and is just generally alright, but kind of slow. And you'll notice from the costs give you a pretty strong indication of how good they are. So like the goof and the Gundam, significantly more expensive and contribute more to the overall cost, whereas that crappy little repair gym is super, super cheap. And again, in there, the level 59 fire support Zaku is obviously far better than any of the other crappy Zaku and gym models that I got in there. Oh, and come on, I'm running out of things to say at this point. It's taking its sweet ass time. As usual, there will be a skip to combat button available, or you can look in the doobly-doo and it will have the things you can click to get to certain points in the video. Because I'm not going to make you unnecessarily suffer through all of my blithering. Right, so if I sort by cost there, I can see what my best suits are. So there's a fantastic specialised water suit there. That'll be, yeah, grabby claw type thing. So it'll have extending claws that rip unsuspecting non-water mobile suits to pieces. That looks like a high-end gym, something almost Gundam-like. I still need to look up some of these. Unlike the Japanese version, the Japanese version is actually really helpful because it has Romanji in there, which is English Latin alphabet text, which makes it really easy to tell what some of them are. With this, I'm just having to go off the picture, which isn't quite so helpful. I have here a rental gun cannon, which I do love a gun cannon, and they work in space, which is another big advantage to those. And I've got some random gym Gundam type things here as well, but it's all Federation ones there. I much prefer the decent Zeon suits, and here we get into like your trash, your Zaku and Jim variants that you really don't want to touch with a barge pole. They're so cheap. Oh, sweet. Basic things. I mean, I've already basically outgrown them. My stable is significantly better than most of that stuff. You look at what I've got here. Okay, admittedly there's the rentals there cleaning up the place, but I've got that Gundam, which is pretty good. I've got that Zaku, which is alright, and I got that Jim. It's not a terrible set that I've got, and once I have used up all the rentals and start really developing my own mobile suits, I'll probably have an all-star cast of Doms and Gundams and specialized Zeon mobile suits for water and space, like Zigooks and stuff. Oh my lord, will you let me into the match, please? I'm gonna fall asleep at this rate. I mean, literally, I'm gonna fall asleep. The trouble is, I don't want to go off and make tea, because if I come back, then I'm gonna find myself completely without any opportunity to jump into the game, because the game will have already started without me and I'll have no points, and then that'll take down my point average, and then I won't be able to rank up, and that'll be very sad. And you know, it's really, really hard to talk non-stop like this for an hour. There's a reason why Yahtzee's Ramblematic videos only go on for like 5 minutes or so. Oh, this is so exhausting continuing to talk for all of this. On the plus side, I'm not having to talk while playing as much, which is an exceptionally difficult thing to do, and it's always good practice as an acquired skill to get used to talking on and on and on and on and on, because it makes you better at speeches and talks and of course YouTube videos. It does mean though that in conversations you can sometimes start rambling and not have people catch up with you, but maybe I should just start randomly clicking some of these and see what happens. Right, so these are just the sub-menus of all the other sub-menus here. That's buyback. What is that one? Oh, yeah, if you have exchange tickets, you can exchange things that you don't want for exchange tickets, and then you can exchange the exchange tickets for high-end consumable stuff. So like this 6-star skin is actually gives you the ability to add skins. So if I were to take my Gundam, for example, not that one, that one. I can use the I can use those update tickets to upgrade the core on this, which is helpful. If I get up to the major levels, I think you get those from playing as well, but you can kind of cheat it by spending the dream ones. Ah, here we go. So yeah, if you get these sprays and these decals, you can use the decals and the ranks that you unlock. So I've got I've got the ability to put, say, that decal on, but I'd need 3 of those, and I've only got 1 presently, and they're quite difficult to get hold of, but you can gradually over time start to improve the chaviness of this. You can also obviously buy with real money each of the parts. I don't remember roughly how much things cost. It escapes me. I did buy some stuff in Japanese version. I just got through a tenner at it or something to see how far a tenner would actually take me, and I really want a Rickdom. Actually, thinking about it, how much would a Rickdom cost in coins? See, this is what happens. You go, oh god, I really wish I had one of these mobile suits. That's a land one only, so that's definitely not a Rick. Ooh, they don't have Rick DOMs available through the store directly, but I can get a standard DOM. If I were to get a standard DOM with the... It doesn't have a beam saber. Can I equip it with a beam saber? Oop, there we go. And we're finally into the game. That took long enough. Take us onwards! So tired of filling in time. If anybody actually watches that section, I apologize profusely. I'm sure nobody will, but if you do, I hope you really love the melancholic sound of my voice. Some people like British accents. I find that weird. Some people go, oh, I love your accent. Usually Americans, for some reason Americans really like a Yorkshire accent. I remember getting, I think it was getting that, or maybe it's getting the kernel level just above those. There was one rank here where I was so glad to get it. I've worked for a full week to just get one of the ranks, and I've practiced and practiced and practiced on maps. Is this a map that I know? I'm hoping that I actually get a map that I know at some point. There's so many maps on this game, and knowing the maps is crucial to playing them. You'll notice that I tend to get attacked from, like, the sides, or somebody just appears where I think I'm safe, and I'm not even facing them. That's because actual map control and understanding the map is one of the most important aspects of this game. Being able to shoot straight doesn't get you that far. And that's one of the reasons I like it, because it's not just skill, direct skill based, it's a lot of indirect skills. It plays almost like a MOBA in the sense that you have to know where people are going to be positioned, what capabilities their mobile suits have, and generally pay attention to what's going on, actually display some proper skill. So we can take out the Gundam, that'll be nice. It's kind of a support setup that it's currently got, but I'll also try and see if we can get some use out of the beam saber. I'll definitely be taking the goof out, and the goof as well should have lots of energy. I think these two have plenty of energy, but you'll notice as well they have a massive timer, so once they get destroyed I'm not going to be able to use them nearly as much. It's always a good idea to have a support thing in there, or a crappy Zaku as backup, so you can take them out when all of your other mobile suits are dead, and you know to then keep safe and keep those alive and interesting. That's white base. Let's take out the Gundam. I have no idea what I'm going to face, and that's a general purpose one anyway. So I'm guessing we want to try maybe to take energy canisters to white base. Since there isn't a Federation and a Zeon side, I have no idea how it works it out, which one should be defending and which one should be attacking the objectives. Presumably just memorize that the red ones are attacking. I suppose if you could read Chinese, that would severely help in deciding what you were going to do. I can also follow what other people are doing to give myself an idea of what's happening on the map, and gradually build up a sense of, oh yeah, this is what I'm supposed to do. And that's why nobody else took this route, because it has Gelgu fucking pain if you go that way. Jeez, fair enough. Ow. Ow. My face. Ow. And that's the problem with not knowing the map. By going through that door rather than the other doors, I completely open myself up to that style of attack. You have to learn the maps before you can go on the attack with this. Oh yeah, it also has a chain gun, which is surprisingly good for such a throwaway weapon. I think that was a bot, but I'm taking credit for the kill anyway. I don't care that it was a bot. I'm also going to go this way because I can sneak up behind this guy. he says, there's so many areas I could get attacked from behind here. Oh, this is so much more powerful than the Zaku's. I'd forgotten how nice it was to take out a goof. They are so much better than the standard mobile suits. Everything is just so much faster, the weapon's so much more effective. I can actually hit things and do damage and get kills. Fantastic. Ooh, you get points for destroying those. Whatever those are. Okay. Jamming going on as well. Woohoo! I do love a goof. So I can do this attack. This spinny attack, or slicey attack, which is fan-frigging-tastic. It just gives you so much of an advantage to be able to use that. Bear in mind that that repair point is there, and I can use it to repair as we progress further into the level. Also, if I can stick around teammates, I greatly increase the chance that I'm not just going to get randomly flanked and ganked. Since I'm out in the open here, probably want to keep the chain gun. Once seems I'm in a confined space, switch to the sword. You learn to fear that sound. Somebody gets a lock on you, run away! God, these new maps are fascinating. This is very, very complicated. The scary thing is the maps on this are really well balanced as well. Even though they tend to be asymmetric, they tend to be incredibly balanced. The way they do stuff. I think you're getting points just for hanging around. Like, maybe this is some kind of objective area I need to be in. Oh, I believe there's also sort of auto lock-on, auto-aim stuff. And the higher end your suits get, the less auto-aim you get. Which is a nice way to bring new players into the fold. I tend not to use a lock, as you probably noticed, because it informs the enemy that you're there. But you can use the... Oh god, I've missed it. You can use the lock to give you a certain amount of auto-aim with certain mobile suits and certain setups. And yes, I'm definitely getting points for contributing to this battle area just by being around, which is good. Oh god. There's attacks and shit going down. Oh, and once you've got a, if you've got a lock with the melee, that can seriously help as well. So I'm mainly, as you probably noticed, just trying to stay out of trouble so I can respawn with the Gundam, and not with the, oh god, with something really crappy. Flee, flee. Don't know where I'm fleeing to or from, but flee. That's probably not a good sign. Let's be careful as to how I do this. Ow! And no amount of amazing close quarter technology will help you if you are as shit as me at playing the game as I am at the moment. So we'll take out these all now. And then once I get more of a hang of it. Oh god, we're not holding the battle area, which is never a good thing. We want to be holding this area, so this is how I'm getting a trickle of points, which is great. But at the same time, it puts me in the line of fire, which is not great. But it's nice. It's a bit more frantic when it's working this way. Scared the shit out of me, mate. Ah. Well, that was embarrassing. I should have totally got on that kill. Still, I've gotten way more points on this mission than anyone I've done previously. Because I'm just managing to stay alive. Mostly. Which is all you need once you're in this battle area, as it phrases it. I assume if I chill around here, I'll probably get demolished by indirect artillery fire. But let's not do that. We'll see how the Gundam stacks up. Oh god, I'm not going in that direction. That's a freaking horrible idea. But I'd like to see how the Saber stacks up. Probably not that well since it's me using it, but hey. Still can't get used to the fact that I'm fighting both Federation and the unmobile suits. That's always gonna feel weird. Alright. Play support. Do I even have any mobile suits I can take out? No, no I don't. Oh lord, I'm that bad. I'm so bad I can't even deploy on the map. Wow. That's a certain level of terrible. Dear. I'm guessing that value up there refers to how much control we have over the battle area. So the more we can push into that area, the better. Looks like this match is going to be over really shortly. Was I on the red team or the blue team? I think I was on the red team. Bollocks. Let's... Oh wow, I have like the world's worst little crappy Uzi thing as well. Just in case I want to use that. But I think just by being in the battle area, I'm sort of helping. We lost, didn't we? Oh no, god! They lost! Yay! Go us! Woohoo! Victory! That was me. And I did not entirely terribly. It's all thanks to those support points, but yeah, I got two kills as well. Go me. I'm feeling pretty good about that. Yeah. I got a rank up. Lovely. Yes, yes. I got a green Gashcon thing, and that's improved my points. Good stuff. The better you do, the more of these things you get at the end, as you've probably gathered. So, ooh, that's the one I really wanted, but meh. And I think I'll call the video there. I might play another couple of games, but I don't feel like talking through a whole bunch of them. Once I'm a little bit better at the game, and had a bit of practice on these maps and got my mobile suits up a bit, I'll do another video with some proper gameplay where you can see me playing maybe half decently. Thank you very much for watching, and I shall see you in future.